All right, news break coming in days after Pakistan Prime Minister Imran Khan lectured India on tolerance. Now, former Indian cricketer Mohammad Kaif has slammed the Pakistan Prime Minister. Kaif tweeted, and I quote, "There were around 20% minorities at the time of partition in Pakistan. Less than 2% remain now. On the other hand, minority population has grown significantly in India. Pakistan is the last country that should be lecturing any country on how to treat minorities." Well, listen in to what Pakistan Prime Minister had said earlier, to which Mohammad Kaif has reacted.
आज के हिंदुस्तान में मैं अभी वो नसीरुद्दीन शाह का पढ़ा था, जो एक्टर, वो जो आप बातें कर रहे हैं, वो सारी वो चीजें हैं जो कायदे आजम तब कर चुके थे कि उन्होंने कहा था कि हिंदुस्तान में मुसलमानों को बराबर का शहरी नहीं समझा जाएगा, वो आज हिंदुस्तान में हो रहा है। पाकिस्तान में ये साबित करना है कि हमने अपने जो भी माइनॉरिटीज हैं, जो भी अकेले हैं, हमने उनको बराबर के शहरी बनाना है। और ये सबसे ज्यादा हमने खास तौर पे नरेंद्र मोदी के हिंदुस्तान को बताना है कि हम अपनी अकलियतों को कैसे रखते हैं और आप अपनी अकलियतें कैसे रखते हैं।
I want to connect to my colleague Gaurav Sawant, executive editor, who's getting us up to speed with this latest news break. Gaurav, Mohammad Kaif is not the first Indian to actually point out the dichotomy in the statement made by the Pakistan Prime Minister.
Cutting across political lines, social lines, religious lines, every Indian almost has responded and shown a mirror to Pakistan's Prime Minister Imran Khan. So you've had political leaders from the Congress, from the BJP, from the AIMIM, they've responded. You have people from the civil society responding. You've had Nasiruddin Shah himself responding. And now you have Mohammad Kaif, so somebody from the cricketing fraternity, telling Pakistan's Prime Minister Imran Khan not only to back off, but also showing him a mirror, saying while minorities have increased in India since 1947, Hindus are down to less than 1% in Pakistan. Sikhs are down. Ahmadis, the way they are being treated, Pakistan actually needs to look within before trying to take advantage of a political situation or a political statement that's been made in India, Preeti.
Thank you, Gaurav, for joining us. Let's get in some political reactions. RP Singh from the Bharatiya Janata Party on the phone line with me. Mr. Singh, you know, the fallacy of the statement made by the Pakistan Prime Minister only smacks on the kind of reactions it's invoking in India.
Well, that's true, that because Indians, whether it's a Muslim or Sikh or a Christian or a Hindu, we are all together, and then we'll sort out, if there are issues, we'll sort it out internally. We don't need any person from other country to tell us what to do, what not to do. And secondly also, I'm with Mr. Nasiruddin Shah when he speaks about Bulandshahr, but when he speaks that he feels sad about his children, that's a little worrisome. And then before making such statement, he should have thought, introspect twice. I mean, he has all the right to criticize government, or he has all the right to raise concern about what happened in Bulandshahr. But to say that children are not safe, I mean, that's a little too far-fetched. Because we have faced the ultimate in the Holocaust strike, where more than 3,406 were killed. I was a young chap that time, and even that time we never thought that we had to run out this country, or we were worried about that, how our future will be. I mean, this nation bounced back, and we had to take as a prime minister after some time.
All right, appreciate you joining us, Mr. Singh. I'll come back to you for more updates later. Meanwhile, let's shift focus in the bulletin.
Thanks for watching the video. For more such news and updates, please like, share and subscribe to India Today. Also, check out our other great videos from our channel. We know you will love to.